again. Bandwidth of the signal is range frequency occupied by amplitude modulated waveform. The difference between the highest frequency and the lowest frequency signal component. Yeah. Bandwidth 1.0 15 minus 0.9 plus equals to 0.030. Yeah. Or bandwidth equals to F carrier, frequency carrier, plus frequency modulation, minus frequency carrier, minus frequency modulation. Ini equals to 2 FM ya, karena sama aja dengan lebar pita ini. Ya, lebar pita. Oke. Where is FM carriers where wave have more to segment frequency for its signal frequency has requires greater bandwidth. Oke. You can see also this material, yeah, this resume on a book, your book. Yeah, actually, this is same thing with in book. Yeah, you can open your book if you your book is near with you. This is about page 311. Yeah, 311. Yeah, about frequency modulation. 311, you can open it, yeah, if you want to see. We only one meeting in this day, yeah, about communication. So mudah-mudahan ini kalian mengerti ya. Nanti baca-baca lagi di buku, ya, tentang communication or radio wave. Okay. Then modulated carrier waves are used rather than the direct transmission of electromagnetic wave having audio frequency due to shorter error required, longer transmit range, lower transmit power, less attenuation, allows more than one station in the region or less distortion. Yeah. Advantage of FM. Yeah. Bapak kira kalian suka mendengarkan radio FM ya? Yeah. Nah, kelebihannya apa sih? Bagusnya itu di mana? Ini electrical interference effect FM more than FM. Yeah. Higher bandwidth can be used due to greater range of frequency available has better quality. Advantage AM. Yeah. Kayaknya kemarin udah ya. The actual receiver transmitter used for AM less complicated and cheaper from FM transmitter. Kalau M itu lebih mudah, lebih murah, cuma lebih agak berisik ya. The bandwidth needed for AM transmission less than FM. Bandwidth-nya kecil. Hence, more station are available given frequency range. AM transmission use lower frequency than FM. Yeah. Hence, can be diffracted, so can cover large area than FM transmission for the same power output. Oke, okay. As I mentioned before, ya, this resume, this apa namanya, conclusion already on the book, ya, yeah, on the chapter communication in page around 300 something, 311. Oke, okay. Now a digital signal consists of series of 1 second and 0 second, ya. Yeah. Analog signal that continuously variable having continuous possible values. Nah, this is analog and digital signal ya. This is analog ya, analog on the decimal number, and this is digital on digital number on binary number ya, 0 and 1. Okay, noise, unwanted power on signal in random. This is amplification of signal amplifies the noise same time. Regeneration will remove the noise from digital signal. Advantage data transmission digital from compact analog. Noise can be eliminated. Yeah. Jadi kalau ini tuh noise-nya kecil karena dia dalam bentuk data digital. Ya, tidak ada apa namanya rentang amplitude yang naik turun. Ya, cenderung constant. Multiplexing possible, digital circuit are more reliable or cheaper. Ya, data can be encrypted for security. Data ini bisa disimpan ya untuk keperluan keamanan. Nah, ini yang kemarin Bapak bilang, kalian harus bisa merubah ini ya, tapi ada di kalkulator, ya ada di kalkulator. Nanti coba-coba gunakan kalkulator ya, try to do your calculator to change ya, about decimal to binary or binary to decimal ya. Ini salah satu contoh yang ada di buku juga ya. In page you can open it in page 315 ya, about change from decimal to binary ya. 0 0 1 1 2 is 10, this is not 10 ya. 3 equals to 11, this is not 11, 11. 4 is 100, 5 is 101 ya. Yeah. Not 101, not 100 ya. Yeah. But 0 101 and 6 is 110, 7 is 11 dan seterusnya. Each digit in binary number known as a bit. Nah, ini dikatakan sebagai bit. Berapa bit? Kalian kalau nanti belajar teknologi komputer. Nah, ya ini adalah basic kalian belajar teknologi komputer. Basic belajar kalian pengetahuan komputer, hardware, software, and programming. Ya. Programming also actually about binary number. Function of ADC. ADC is analog to digital converter. Merubah dari analog menjadi digital. Nah, ini analog tuh kayak gini, ya. Analog and this digital. Ya. Digital signal consists of series 1 and 0, ya. Analog this is not second 1 and 0s, ya. Beberapa 1 dan beberapa 0. Analog digital signal contains variable having contain possible value. Berapapun nilainya ya, ini tidak bergantung pada angka 0, 1, 3, 4, desimal berapa negatif also. Oke, okay, I back again. Ya. Yeah. Kayaknya ini udah ya. Oh, this is also in your book ya. Yeah. Suggest effect quality of recording of sampling at higher frequency than frequency. High frequency can be reproduced. Okay. Nanti kalian bisa lihat ini di buku, ya. Bisa dilihat di buku di page adanya. Sebenarnya apa yang ada di sini adalah apa yang ada di buku in page 316. You can see here this is about how to change analog. The analog when they on the let's say this is 100 microsecond, they have 10. So 10 we change into binary number equals to 1010, yeah, 1010. Yeah, let's see, 10 is 1010. Yes, this is correct. Yeah. Again, I repeat again, how to change from decimal and binary? I asked to Pak Budi, katanya anak-anak sudah bisa kok merubah dari decimal ke binary dengan calculator. Jadi ada dua cara dengan menghitung manual, ya. Dengan membagi dua setiap desimal itu, dan ada dengan menggunakan kalkulator. Saran Bapak supaya karena kalian bisa boleh menggunakan kalkulator, gunakan kalkulator aja. Itu ada di mode base, ya. Mode base, ubah dari digital to analog. From analog to digital, ya. Yeah. From decimal to binary, yes.
Why do we need binary numbers?
Binary numbers?
Yeah.
Kenapa, Jeff?
What? Binary numbers? What is it for?
Oh, this is for ini, for encrypt. Sebenarnya itu for memudahkan kita mengubah gini. Data encrypted ya. Data yang diubah kalau desimal itu besar, gini, Bapak contohkan gini. Nah, this one. We have analog. Analog is decimal ya. 10, 9, 8, 6, 3. And the analog we can convert into binary. Nah, from this binary we can like save ya. Jadi dari binary ini bisa kita simpan dengan mudah ya dibandingkan kita menggunakan ini. Seperti Bapak contohkan analog itu kaset zaman dulu ya, kaset. Kalian kalau dengar musik zaman dulu kaset pakai putaran, pakai magnetik. Nah, itu masih analog. Kemudian pindah ke digital, digital dalam bentuk CD, disk. Nah, ini mempermudah untuk transmisi ataupun mempermudah untuk data penyimpanan sebenarnya ya, atau data transformasi ke objek yang lainnya. Pengiriman data lebih ke arah situ. Memudahkan pengiriman data atau memudahkan penyimpanan data. Karena kalau data-data seperti ini harus dengan benda penyimpan tertentu. Nah, tapi kalau kita pakai encrypted ini, ya dalam bentuk bilangan biner, itu akan mudah kita simpan. Nah, seperti itu. Oke, ini adalah analog to digital conversion. Ini analog digital. Ya. Nah, tapi kalau kita digital to analog konversi, ini kita ubah ya from digital to analog. Akhirnya kotak-kotak seperti ini. Ya. Ya. Nah, seperti itu. Okay, there are difference in the digital signal in ADC, analog digital converter, and DAC, digital analog converter. Level of detail, the transmit signal can be increased by, nah ini increase number, a bit is number similar to having extra significant feature, to reduce step height, yeah, resultant, the smaller change input signal can be seen. Okay, and increase sampling rate, the number. Okay, I repeat again ya, about analog digital or digital to analog. Same thing kayak misalkan Bapak bicara seperti ini, kerekam ke dalam mikrofon, ya, yang Bapak bicara ini sebenarnya adalah analog, ya, sampai ke dalam mikrofon. Dia record, nah recordnya itu kemudian dia ubah ke dalam data digital, ya data digital. Data digital ini di dalam laptop atau komputer mudah untuk diproses, karena dalam bentuk data-data mudah, ya data-data simple angka 1 dan 0, ya angka 1 dan 0. Nah kemudian sampai proses berikutnya, ya. Dibalikan lagi ke dalam loudspeaker. Loudspeaker diubah menjadi data analog lagi, menjadi analog. Ya. Dari bilangan biner ini kemudian dibikin satu trace, jejak menjadi analog. Ya. Seperti itu. Okay. Kemudian, nah ini signal attenuation, ya. Loss of signal power. Oke, Bapak, apa namanya? Simulasi kan seperti ini ya. Ya, Bapak analogikan seperti ini, ya. Ketika ini data analog, aslinya seperti ini. Bapak ketika bicara seperti ini. Kemudian hanya mengambil pada satu sampling rate, ya, sampling-sampling ini, ya. Di time, ya, dengan jeda tertentu membikin satu data digital, ya. Data digital itu seperti yang tadi Bapak bilang diproses dulu, nah, kemudian diubah menjadi analog lagi. Ya. Nah, ketika dijadi analog lagi ini kan tidak sama persis dengan yang ini, ya. Tidak sama persis dengan yang ini. Maka itu yang namanya adalah loss of signal power, ya. Ada yang hilang, ya. The decrease in signal power from the transmit value P1 that the receiver P2 can be very high. Hence ratio P2 P1 measured by logarithmic scale. Oh, kemudian ini adalah hitungannya ya, hitungannya. The logarithmic base 10, yes, ratio give number bell, ya, ini unitnya ya, in bell. When the multiplied 10 give the number decimal dB. Yeah. Number of B, yeah, it's logarithm P2 over P1. Yeah, number of B logarithm P2 over P1. Yeah. Number of dB ini desibel ya, equals to 10 logarithm P2 over P1. Yeah. For example, suppose P2 is 100 tremgitter P1, yeah. Andaikan P2 ini adalah 1000 kali dari P1, maka number of decibel, yeah. dB is decibel, ya. Yeah. Decibel equals to 10 logarithma because this is P2 1000 times of P1. Yeah, this is equal to 1000 over 1. Yeah. Logarithma 1000 is 3. Yeah. So log 1003, 3 times 10 equals to 30. So number of decibel signal attenuation-nya itu equals to 30 decibel. Yeah. That's it. Okay, I hope you understand ya. Yeah. This is an example. This is an example. So we can see here also in book also ya. Yeah. Di dalam buku ada juga ini. Ya. Yeah. Di halaman signal of power. Oh. This on 319, yeah, on the 319. A signal of power 18 milliwatt passes along one cable, where the attenuation is 20 dB is passed along another cable. Where the attenuation is 30 dB, yeah, what is the power? The end of cable. Okay, step one, yeah. Now we know about 18.0 milliwatt is P1, I think. Yeah. No. The first one we have attenuation in 20 dB, yeah, and the second one is 30 dB. Step one, apply the decibel equation for each cable, turn in the first cable, if input P1 or the pot P2. 20 equals to 10 logarithm P1 over P2. Yeah, P1 over P2. Wait. First cable, yeah. Notice that both side equation produce positive numbers since P1, P2. Oh, I see. In the second cable, the input P2, the output of the channel output P3, then 30 equals to 10 logarithm P2 over P3. I think this is about mathematical calculation, yeah. When 20 plus 30, yeah. Kita tambahkan antara 20 dengan 30 itu sama dengan ini ditambah dengan ini ya, maka muncul 50 equals to 10 times logaritma P1 over P2 plus logaritma P2 over P3. Then this on the logarithmic low ya, hukum logaritma ketika ditambahkan ini sama aja dikali ya. Logaritma let's say a plus logaritma b equals to logaritma a times b ya, a times b ya, p1 over p2 times p2 over p3, so we can cancel p2 p2 ya, just 10 equals to p1 over p3 equals to 50 ya, that's it. This so that total attenuation of the cable is 50 decibel equals the sum of attenuation of the consecutive channel. Hence, you can add attenuations to find the total attenuation, but the carnival signal is being applied attenuated. Okay, we have P1, yeah, this one, yeah, 18.0 milliwatt. Yeah, then we can, by substitute, we can get P3, yeah. 50 divided by 10 equals to 5, yeah. Equals to logarithma 18 power divided by P3. So 5, this is same thing with logarithma 10 power 5, yeah. So after that, 18 equals to P3 times 10 power, yeah. Same thing with 1.8 times 10 power minus 4 milliwatt. Okay, you could apply decibel equation here. Okay, this is about attenuation. Yeah. Now, attenuation per unit length, unit dB, kilometer. Okay. Yeah. Okay, this is other attenuation. Attenuation per unit length, unit dB per kilometer minus 1 given by ini dB over kilometer ya, equals to tadi attenuation kita ganti divided by length of cable in kilometer. Yeah. Okay, when the signal travel along a cable, the level of noise is important. Hence, the signal to noise ratio in dB given by, nah ini signal to noise ratio. Ini penting sekali nanti kalian kalau belajar ilmu komunikasi ya. Bagaimana membandingkan signal power dengan noise ya, untuk mendapatkan hasil yang bagus. Ya, this is equal to 10 logarithma signal power over noise power. Okay, in analog signal at regular level, multiplying both among gives. Okay, as I mentioned before, this is already in book. Yeah, we only explanation from the book. You can open it also. Yeah, it's mean like what I mentioned. One is high and zero is low. Yeah, one equals like they have voltage, they have potential, they have dia punya tegangan. Nol ini dia tidak punya tegangan, ya, sama seperti. Coba kita lihat contohnya, ya. You can see here on page the input on page 319, ya, 319. Okay. The input signal cable has power 1.2 times 10 power minus 3 watt. Yeah. The signal attenuation per unit length in cable 14 dB yeah. Per kilometer. Yeah, kilometer. Average noise level along cable constant 1.0 times 10 power minus 3. Yeah. An acceptable signal to noise ratio at least 30 decibel. Calculate the minimum acceptable power for the signal, maximum length, the cable that can be used without repeater. Okay, signal to noise, yang tadi ini, yang this one. Signal to noise ratio is 10 logarithma signal power over noise power. We have a signal power 1.2. Then we have average noise level 1.0, yeah. Yeah, from this, also we have 30 decibel is signal to noise ratio, yeah. Kita punya di sini, signal to ratio is 30 decibel and noise power 1.0. So we can find signal power here, yeah, like this one. 30 signal to noise ratio, yeah, equals to 10 logarithma P signal power. We need to find first, yeah, and then noise power 1.0 times 10 power. Then after we calculate this, we get P equals to 1.0 times 10 power minus 7 watt. Yeah, Ini dari ini 30 bagi 10 kan 3 ya. 3 ini minus 10 berarti minus 7. Ya, 1.0 times 10 power minus 7 watt. Then step 2, the repeater needed signal when the signal was to in example its power 10 times noise level and this we can calculate attenuation needed. Okay, attenuation itu kan tadi P1 over P2 ya. Yeah. P1 is 1.2 ya yeah. And then P2 is this one ya. Yeah. Signal power ya. Yeah. So 10 power 1.2 times 10 minus 3 divided by 1.0 times 10 power minus 7 ya. Yeah. Equals to 41 decibel ya. Yeah. Ya. Yeah. You can use this by your calculator ya. Yeah. Tinggal tik-tik aja. Oke, hence the length cable. Ya, kita lihat kalau yang tadi ya this ya. Attenuation per unit tank, unit length is dB over kilometer length of cable ya. Attenuation dB divided by length of cable. So length of cable equals to attenuation between attenuation for a unit length. Ya, yeah. Ini 41 is attenuation and 14. Ya, yeah, 14 is apa tadi? Nah ini, ya. Yeah. Attenuation over length. Ya. Yeah. Atau apa attenuation for over length ya 14 so 41 divided by 14 equals to 2.9 kilometer so the distance is 2.9 ya from where this equation is from this ya this one attenuation per unit length we already provide this is about this one 14 dB per kilometer. Yeah. Then attenuation we already get. This is around 41 dB. So we get the length of cable is 2.9 kilometer. If the cable is 10 kilometer length, the total attenuation is yes 14 dB per kilometer times equals to the signal power 1.2 attenuation to power P. Yes. Ketika dia bertanya 10 kilometer, ya. Sorry, in 10 kilometer, same thing with times 14 dB over kilometer. Because per meter is 14. Ya. The signal power 1.2 times 10 power minus 3. Yes, what is from power P? So, in 10 meter, ya, 140 equals to 10 logaritma. This is same thing with this one, yeah. 0.0012 divided by P. So power equals to 12 times 10 minus 17 watt. This is power until in 10 kilometer, yeah, in 10 kilometer. Okay, that's it. You can see the power, the signal much smaller than minimum acceptable power. Yes. It is even smaller than the noise level. The signal to noise ratio, yes. Yeah, we put this power in here, yeah. Signal to ratio, signal power, this signal power, yeah, divided by noise power. Noise power is in here. Yeah. Equals to 79 decibel. Smaller than acceptable, 30 decibel. A repeater is needed will before enter 10 kilometer kabel. Kayak diperlukan lagi. Jadi kayak sinyalnya hilang atau sinyalnya noise-nya terlalu besar sehingga harus ada repeater. Ya. Oke, nah ini different channel of communication. Both wire ya. Oh, ini coaxial kabel. Ya betul. Terlalu terburu-buru ya. Ini sebenarnya ya tadi Bapak bilang ada di buku ya tentang coaxial kabel. Oh ya, kita sampai dengan 9:10 ya, biar sekalian istirahatnya nanti. Now still 8:51, so we have around 19 more minutes ya. Yeah, I explain about this. Yeah, this is already in book. Yeah, you can open it in your book. Again, around 300, around page 320. Yeah, sekarang tentang wire. Yeah, different channel of communication. Wire pairs. Yeah, application linking land telephone to local exchange. The potential difference between two wires is the signal. Each wire at the aerial pick up wanted electromagnetic wave distort the signal. However, when two wires close together, each wire picks up equal amount of electrical interference, and no additional potential difference between two wires, and so having wires close together reduce the interference. Kalau punya dua wires kemudian didekatkan, ini akan mereduce interference ya, malah menghilangkan interferensi. A wire pairs is the cheapest transmitter medium. Ya, emang yang paling mudah medium transmisinya. And has a small bandwidth. Bandwidth-nya kecil. Tadi bandwidth itu adalah lebar pita ya. Lebar pita itu artinya frekuensi carrier plus frekuensi modulasi dikurang frekuensi carrier dikurang frekuensi modulasi. Ya, tadi Bapak bilang ini frekuensi modulasi nanti semuanya equals to two times of frekuensi modulasi. Dia adalah jeda ya. Nah, nanti semuanya kalau kalian lihat ini pita, ini frekuensi carrier, dia membawa berita itu dengan suatu carrier ya, frekuensi tertentu, dan ini modulasi ya. Maka pada suatu rentang tertentu frekuensi carrier minus frekuensi modulasi, frekuensi carrier plus frekuensi modulasi. Nah, bandwidth itu adalah dari titik ini sampai dengan titik ini. Ya, bandwidth equals to two times of frekuensi modulasi. Oke. Back again to this. Okay, this one. Yeah. Reflection occur due poor impedance matching. Wire pairs are easily tapped, hence low security. Suffer from cross-linking where signal pairs become neck porting wire pair, resulting to crosstalk. Lock attenuation or energy loss due to charge to due to changing current wire produce electromagnetic field, hence acting aerial requires electromagnetic wave might be wires to another leading crosstalk. Oh yeah. When you remember about electromagnetic wave, when you remember about electrostatic, when you remember about electric field, yeah, that's when the wire or when the copper, they have electric current, they will make a induce electromagnetic or electromagnetic induction. Mm. Nah, itu kenapa ini ada semacam copper wire yang dia melapisi ini ya, supaya saling meniadakan, saling they have electromagnetic effect, so they do in different factor, so it will be neglected. Kayak misalkan ini menghasilkan induksi elektromagnetik, ini menghasilkan induksi elektromagnetik also, dan antar keduanya itu saling berlawanan, berhadapan, maka resultanya akan zero. Nah, seperti itu. Application connecting aerial to a television. Nah, ini kalau kalian pernah lihat TV zaman dulu yang pakai antena yang di atas, tapi sekarang udah sangat jarang ya. Ini adalah kabelnya seperti ini ya, kabel koaksial. Di dalam ada kabel satu, dan di setelah ada insulator ini, dia ada kabel serabutnya. apa woven cover wire. Ini kayak serabut-serabut kecil. Last croaking alien crosstalk with wire pairs, yeah, copper braid. Okay. For noise external signal. Greater bandwidth than wire pairs, yeah. Has less attenuation for unit length of wire pairs, prevent any emission of can transmit data faster over longer distance with less electric interference noise. Ini bisa apa mentransmisikan data secara cepat ya dengan jarak yang sangat jauh ya. With less electrical interference. Nah, itu maksudnya adalah kayak tadi saling meniadakan ya neglected about electromagnetic effect. Ya, walaupun ada tapi saling menghilangkan sehingga ini kita bisa sebut sebagai less electrical interference. Ya. Electrical interference itu sama dengan noise. Ya. More expensive wire pair, ya. Lebih mahal daripada wire pairs. Okay, no radio wave. Nah, can open it on your book in page. Same thing of still in 3021. Yeah. This is radio wave, yeah. Electromagnetic wave covering a vast range of wavelength use the variety of communication depending on frequency. There are three types. Ada tiga tipe, ya. Kalau kalian ingat yang kemarin Bapak bilang ada AM, ada FM. Ada amplitude modulation, ada frequency modulation. Yang sering kalian dengarkan adalah frequency modulation or FM, ya. Seperti Jack FM, Ardan FM, apa lagi ya, Sky FM ya. AM itu zaman dulu, tapi sekarang masih ada juga. Ya, yang kemudian adalah SW, short wave ya. There are three types ya. Tiga tipe SW, AM, and FM. This is depends by range of frequency. Beda-beda frekuensi. Zaman dulu waktu mungkin kakek kalian itu masih menggunakan SW, short wave, ya. Kemudian zamannya bapak banyak menggunakan AM, amplitude modulation. Nah, kemudian zamannya sekarang kalian FM. Tapi maybe FM udah mulai mau hilang lagi karena mungkin ada teknologi komunikasi yang lebih hebat lagi ya. Okay, this is sky wave greater than 30 MHz are known as space wave. They're passing through ionosphere. Sky wave of 2-3 MHz reflected by ionosphere. Ini ada tipe gini ya. Oh, maksudnya three types itu oh gini. Ini 1, 2, and 3. By satellite, by reflection of ionosphere, and this is directly by air. Yeah. Okay, this is surface wave diffraction around here. This is directly by air ya. Yeah. Directly by air ini harus tidak ada a reflection of the earth. Okay, I go here. Surface wave travel. Okay, mungkin kalian ini baca-baca aja lagi ya. Ini keterangannya banyak kalau kita. Kita ke sini aja. Optic fiber, ya. Fiber optic. Optic fiber on your book is on the page 322. Yeah. Consists of thin glass core surrounded by material slightly lower effective index cladding for total internal reflection. Oke. Okay. Cara kerjanya sebenarnya menggunakan cahaya, tapi cahaya itu kemudian dilewatkan pada fiber ya, optic fiber. Dan ini ada cladding kayak semacam apa insulator ya. Apa namanya? Pelapis dari optic fiber ini. Kalian bisa lihat warna hijau, biru, hitam ini adalah let's say sebagai transmisi, data transmisi ya. Ini kalau merah langsung hijau ataupun hitam dia mengalami reflect ya. Nah, prinsip kerjaan seperti itu ya. Kalau ini dalam optik fiber, kalau yang tadi langsung dilewatkan lewat udara ya. Go directly in the air. But in the fiber optic on the optic fiber ya. Oke, sekarang banyak menggunakan ini. Kalau kalian di Jakarta tiba-tiba ada yang menggali pinggir jalan, nah itu biasa pemasangan ini ya, kabel optiknya. Kabel optik biasanya ditanam di dalam tanah. Method to convert decimal into binary internet. Oh, ya, itu benar. Ya, ini beberapa rings meter but wavelength, panjang gelombang. Radio wave more than 10 power 2 ya. Microwave, infrared dan seterusnya. Ini kayaknya ada waktu itu di kelas 11 ya. Tentang rentang atau range of electromagnetic frequency and wavelength ya. Spectrum ya, we call it a spectrum. Spectrum electromagnetic spectrum. Oh, dan ya, yeah. That's it. Okay, I hope you understand about this. If you still didn't understand, please read again in this book, yeah, in your book. I hope you bring your book into your house, yeah, because this is already in your book also.